Hello friends, I'm CA Jyoti Punjabi and I'm just here to guide all the CA final students specifically, and those students who want a guidance about the, you know, financial reporting amalgamation part. It's just that I just want to upload the lectures for either accounting or financial reporting and strategic financial management subjects subjects related to the core finance areas for professionals also and for chartered accountants also and for other people who are interested towards these or who are interested to learn accounting or financial reporting and core finance areas. So friends, I would like to introduce myself. Basically, I'm a practicing CA and I've been, you know, passionate about teaching, and it's just that I wanna share my knowledge with you all and so that I can guide you and and help you in each and every way I can. So friends, we'll start today with the amalgamation lecture. So amalgamation obviously forms a part of, you know, the CA Inter and CA IPCC as well. So amalgamation, obviously the question comes for 16 marks into the CA final exams, and it's just that we have to take care that we need to, you know, obviously understand the concepts and followed by practice and practice a lot. So basically amalgamation, see, what do you mean by amalgamation? What is amalgamation? Amalgamation actually means to amalgamate or to join. दो चीज़ों का यूनियन होता है amalgamation, means in simple words we can say, and it's just that as per the definition, you know, I have some few notes out here, so I'll go through these points also. So when two or more existing companies goes into liquidation and a new company is formed to take over their business, is known as amalgamation. Actually, it is simply a union, as I said, as per the meaning of this thing. So what happens actually, amalgamation means obviously either the meeting of the two existing companies, or, you know, there are other types of amalgamation too that will be discussed one by one. And as per this definition, as we saw, when two or more existing companies goes into liquidation and new companies form to take over their business, so it's known as amalgamation. And in 1998, Dalmer Benz and Chrysler Corporation announced the world's largest cross-border deal, over valued at $38 billion, and the resulting change in company name to Daimler Chrysler AG. So it's just that we can consider there are two corporations who want to actually liquidate and get into one company. So that scene is known as amalgamation. Okay. See, Daimler Benz and Chrysler Corporation, they formed into one, Daimler Chrysler AG. Okay. Next case, we do have the case of absorption. One or more existing companies goes into liquidation and some existing companies take over the business. Basically, amalgamation, see, for example, A and B goes into liquidation and form a company limited AB, that's amalgamation. But if only B goes into liquidation and A takes over its business, so actually the new company, you know, A will, new company will not form actually, but it's just that A's balance sheet will reflect, you know, the B's all assets, liabilities, and, you know, obviously other things too, you know, the business aspects of B will be included in the financial statements of A, and this case is known as the absorption, which means the taking over of a company by another company, means the taking over of B by A. And see, here we have the Corus Group and the Tata Steel. And the Corus Group, a steel making company headquartered in London, was acquired by Tata in 2007. It's a very, you know, it's a very famous deal between the Tata and the Corus. External reconstruction. Okay. Sorry. Now, this is the third case for amalgamation. Now, one existing company goes into liquidation and new companies form to take over its business. Now, if an existing company takes over, then this is a case of absorption. But if one company goes into liquidation and some other companies formed in that company's place only, means if A goes into liquidation and A goes into liquidation and A new is formed, you know, I'm naming A and A new, so it's just that we can say it's a form of external reconstruction. Means actually, see, here we have got some practical examples over here, as you saw the Corus and Tata Steel wala example, and this thing, RIM and BlackBerry. You know, Research in Motion was the first wireless technology developer in North America. In Jan 2013, the company announced that it would change its name after the widely known smartphone device in an effort to revive the declining brand. So they had to change their brand. So they changed the name, but you know, this external reconstruction is not just about, you know, brand. Here they have the example that shows it actually, you know, is depicting the change, just the change in name. But it's just that the company might have got losses, the company might have got various problems, various financial problems, and to clean their balance sheets, simply they have to go into external reconstruction, and so such things happen, you know. As per their discretion, and obviously with some mandatory formalities, they have to change their name, and this case is known as the external reconstruction. Okay, now we have the transfer company. A company which is being amalgamation or absorption or external reconstruction, it involves the, you know, the involvement of obviously two companies, as we can say. So one should be a transferor company and another transferee company. So here we got the definition. Now, company which is being amalgamated into another company, also known as vendor company, which is being amalgamated into another company, which is means, you know, who is actually selling its business. Fine. So it's vendor company and the transferee company. Company in which transferor company is being amalgamated is known as vendee company. Means obviously A and B are the transferors, and the company ultimately form AB Limited is known as a transferee company. Fine, friends. Now, consideration or aggregate of shares and other securities issued and the payment made in the form of cash and other assets by the transferee company to the shareholders of the transferor company. Obviously, consideration means it's in Hindi we can say the lain den, you know, it's the actual means actually the after the union, the shareholders, the old shareholders are given the shares and that is known as lain dein. I mean, unko exactly kya diya jayega. So the aggregate of shares and other securities issued and the payment made in the form of cash, the shareholders obviously, yaar yahan lain dein chal raha hai, so shareholders to aapke matlab apna company bech raha hai na, so unko bhi to obviously unka jo kuch in return jo unko milega, that is known as the consideration, and wo jo hai aapka shares mein bhi ho sakta hai, other securities mein bhi ho sakta hai, and it and the payment in, can be in the form of cash too and other assets to the shareholders. It is by the transferee company, that is AB Limited, as I've already took an example of A and B Limited amalgamating into AB Limited, and the transferee company, it means the AB Limited, to the shareholders of the transferor company, which means A Limited and B Limited. Okay, these are two companies are amalgamating. So these are some of the definitions, and see, we should consider the case of amalgamation, the five important points that what actually happens during amalgamation. Amalgamation in the nature of merger and amalgamation in the nature of purchase. These are the two types, you know, in which amalgamation occurs basically. These are two nature of amalgamation, you know. Amalgamation in the nature of merger and amalgamation in the nature of purchase. So what happens actually when there is a merger, basically all the assets and liabilities of the transferee of the transferor company becomes, after amalgamation, the assets and liabilities of the transferee company. It's quite a simple point, but you know, these five points are necessary to remember because that will help you to identify the situation as per the problem. And obviously we actually need to remember the FR, the financial reporting aspects, or any of our, you know, theoretical academic aspects to apply into the practical life too. So these five points are very important. Now same equity shareholders holding 90%, we'll actually apply all these points when we'll solve the amalgamation problems, but right now it's just that we need to understand first of all these points. The shareholders hold at least 90% of the face value of the equity shares of the transferor company. Becomes equity shareholders of the transferee company by the virtue of the amalgamation. Actually, shareholders holding, you know, what happens actually, uh, 90% of the shareholders of the transferor company, as in we can say A company and B company, A company limited, A limited and B limited, which are actually forming into AB Limited, then basically 90% of the shareholders have to, you know, give their consent to the, you know, this amalgamation thing and all. And if that happens, then actually that becomes, you know, an amalgamation, the amalgamation becomes successful at that stage. Basically it's a rule by a company's act, obviously. So shareholders holding at least 90% of the face value of equity shareholders of the transferor company becomes equity shareholders of the transferee company by the virtue of amalgamation. This 90% criteria is a rule by the company's act itself. So it's just that it needs to be remember that 90% shareholders should become shareholders of the transferee company. Okay, now purchase consideration in equity shares. Now the consideration of amalgamation receivable by those equity shareholders of the transferor company who agree to become equity shareholders of the transferee company wholly by the issue of equity shares in the transferee company, except that cash may be paid in respect of any fractional shares. And it's just that, you know, The consideration normally in is actually shared in terms of, you know, equity shares, obviously, or fractional shares into cash. So if there is a clear guideline, or if there is a clear identification of the situation as to the, you know, as to the consideration or the give and take of the give and take of the consideration is actually done into the form of equity shares, then we must say that this is the nature of merger into amalgamation. Okay. And same business, the business of the transferor company is intended to be carried on after the amalgamation by the transferee company. This is the most important thing, that the business must be the same of the transferor company and transferee company, and recording of assets and liabilities at book value. Now, no adjustment is intended to be made in the book values of the assets and liabilities of a transferor company when they are incorporated in the financial statements of transferee company, except to ensure uniformity of the accounting policies. Now, if actually the book values need not be changed, they have to be incorporated as it is. Means, obviously, there were assets worth rupees 10 crores into the balance sheet of A Limited and 8 crores into the balance sheet of B Limited. And I'm talking about fixed assets only. So those fixed assets, 10 plus 8 equals 18 crores, they should be reflected into the balance sheet of AB Limited as it is in terms of their book value. And as we will solve the problems of amalgamation, you will get the picture clear as related to all the 5 points over here. Basically, these 5 points are basically essential to remember. Okay, friends. So you have to remember, there must be same business. There, the purchase consideration should be only in equity shares, and fractional shares can be used for cash. The same equity shareholders, they 90% of the equity shareholders of the transferor company must be the equity shareholders of the transferee company. Okay, must become, and there must be the transfer of all the assets and liabilities of the transferor company, and that too, that transfer should means the actual recording must be done in book values only, must be recorded at book values only. Okay. And amalgamation in the nature of purchase. See, all those points are related to merger. And now, if any one of these conditions which is not satisfied, then that cannot be called a merger. If any one. Okay, so all the 5 things are very essential to be identified, and if any one of the conditions is not satisfied, then cannot be called a merger, then it can be called amalgamation in the nature of purchase. Fine. And obviously, they have actually, you know, here I have got notes related to the method of accounting too. I would like to discuss first this point basically. And the PC means the purchase consideration. We actually, when we sell something, if we sell any goods for business, or if we sell, any fixed asset, so whatever we get is known as the consideration in lieu of the asset which we have sold, or in lieu of the goods which we have sold into business, or any other thing. So means it's simply called consideration, and it says that purchase consideration in amalgamation actually means the aggregate of shares and securities issued and payment made in the form of cash or other assets to the shareholders of the transferor company. Okay, friends, consideration can be in the form of shares and securities, cash and other assets. So the aggregate of all those things is known as the purchase consideration. And how will this purchase consideration be derived? Basically, what happens, amalgamation, while amalgamating, or you know, while absorbing any company, means while absorption, or and even in the third case, you know, the reconstruction matters, the companies are valued. Fine, and they are valued using obviously certain criteria, and we'll obviously learn over here. And what happens basically after valuation, the companies they decide how to pay the other company who is actually getting amalgamated into the amalgamated company. Means सामने वाले जो लोग या जो शेयर होल्डर्स अपनी कंपनी हम लोगों को बेच रहे हैं, उन लोगों को पे किस तरीके से करना है, तो वो होता है आपका कंसिडरेशन. ओके फ्रेंड्स, नाउ पेमेंट मेड बाय द ट्रांसफरी कंपनी टू डिस्चार्ज द डिबेंचर होल्डर्स एंड अदर आउटसाइड लाइबिलिटीज एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ वाइंडिंग अप ऑफ द ट्रांसफरर कंपनी शैल नॉट बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ परचेस कंसिडरेशन. दिस इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. कंसिडरेशन ओनली इंक्लूड्स इक्विटी शेयर्स और कैश. Okay, but the cost of winding up or discharging the debenture holders or other outside liabilities, these few things do not come into the purchase consideration. Okay, now the method of calculating purchase consideration. We do have, what happens actually, the purchase consideration non-cash consideration and the future consideration. The shares are to be valued at the fair value of shares, and the security is issued at value fixed by the statutory authority. Other assets handed over means the fair value of the assets given up, and others at the net book value. And the future consideration, if probable amount can be estimated, it is included in the consideration, and in other cases it's recognized when determinable. See what happens actually, when A and B amalgamate to form a company AB Limited. Fine friends, then what happens actually, A will have their own assets, their own liabilities, B will have their own assets and their own liabilities, and the assets are actually recorded at book value. But when there is an exchange of shares, or there is an exchange of assets, means assets are given in lieu of assets, then the fair value is considered. Normally the net book value of all the assets is considered, and if there is a statutory authority involved into the valuation of some assets, then the value fixed by the statutory authority is considered. Or obviously if the investments are involved, investment of shares is involved, means if the investments are part of the assets of any company, and we have to give other consideration to the company in against the shares, so the fair value of that investment is to be considered. So friends, we must understand one thing, that the accounting treatments can be understood only when, you know, we get into the actual accounting. See, I do have few questions over here, but let me, I do have some files, you know, some other notes to be talked about. These are other notes, and it's just that, you know, the amalgamation or the PC obviously can be calculated by two methods. It means net asset method or net payments method. Now, what does net asset method simply means? The deduction of liabilities from the asset, and we get the net amount as the net asset method, you know. Is actually paying the company for their assets, net assets only. Okay. And the other thing, net payment method means the PC, means payment made in any form to equity or preference shareholder of old company by new company. Net payments method, you know, includes, you know, the consideration given in the form of, you know, equity shareholders or obviously cash and other securities. And here are some notes or some points to be considered for amalgamation. Swap ratio or exchange ratio is the ratio for exchange of shares. It can be given in question, obviously. Means the company A is issued 2 shares for every 3 shares held by them, or the company B is issued 1 share for every 2 shares held by them. So, the, you know, we are swapping, we are giving, you know, the shares in the form of shares, shares against shares. So, we are swapping it. And this ratio can be called a swap ratio or the exchange ratio. It will definitely be given into the problem. If swap ratio is missing, then use deemed swap ratio, means value of the old company's share upon value of the new company's share. You know what will happen? Actually, we'll have to check out these points clearly during solving the problems, basically. But here we are actually, you know, trying to understand the basics first of all and the framework. So these values can be intrinsic values, fair value, market value as given in the question, but these are not paid up values or par values until there's a solid reason. Basically, if swap ratio is missing, then the fair value or the market value of shares or the intrinsic value of shares can be given, or can be you know, intrinsic value can be they will ask us to find out that, you know, and we'll obviously find out that value using, you know, the asset minus liability formula and dividing the net assets by the number of shares. That will give us the intrinsic value of that particular company. So that intrinsic value, if we'll, you know, can be used to find out the swap ratio. Fine. And if the question doesn't mention swap ratio as well as value of shares, then the value should be calculated, such value being intrinsic value. Okay. Explain this point's treatment of fractions. Details of shareholders are available. Details of shareholders are not available. Basically, the fractions are actually, you know, settled in cash. And the details when you know when the details of shareholders are available means the information can be available in the question itself. Any information that the shareholder is handling so much number of shares at so much price, so you know we can the means if the shareholder is handling 1576 shares, so if the calculation we can do the perfect calculations up to you know 1500 shares, then what about the value of 76 shares? So what you'll have to do, we'll have to obviously consider those 76 shares and convert it into fractions, you know, or we can say if the shareholders hold 1500.76 shares, then those fraction values can be, you know, converted into cash if the details are available, you know, if the details are available, as in clearly the shareholder has to watch out, or the if the details regarding the shareholders are available, so we have to identify the odd lot for each shareholder and settle in cash, and then settle the even lot as agreed. And if the details are not available, then we have to identify the odd lot for the last shareholder, settle in cash, and settle even lot as agreed. We'll check these points when we'll solve the problems basically. Now calculation of PC. By net payments method involves issue value. Each issue value will be given in question, or value used in deem swap ratio or par value of shares. And now okay friends, I think I should stop over here. Basically I would like to continue some points afterwards, or would like to, you know, directly start our problems and solutions, and that would help us to understand this chapter clearly. Okay friends, I would like to please comment on this video. Aapko video kaisa laga, aap please comment kijiye, and you can also, you know, tell about or suggest me some improvements. You can also demand any topic from your end, that we didn't understood this point or didn't understood that thing. I'll surely make you aware about some points. Basically, you know, the FR is obviously very important subject in group 1 of CA finals, and so I would like you to guide about this subject, you know, at my end, and I will make sure that you know you clear the concepts very well. So please do like, share and subscribe my channel Excellent Institute, and accordingly comment and share your feedback. And in the next videos I would like to, you know, go with or upload the you know, next further part of the problems and solutions related to amalgamation, and some more explanation related to amalgamation, and we'll start solving the problems from the next video. Okay, friends, thank you for the time being. Take care. Bye.